notice has been given of one amendment to this motion, which is set out on page 7 of the supplement. Councillor Jeffrey, you now have 7 minutes to speak on this motion.
Mr. Mayor, we would like to second the amendment.
The amendment is second.
Move to second.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, the notice of motion I've put forward in my name about the Northern urges colleagues of all parties not to squander this once in a lifetime chance. We would lock significant power budgets for our area. Mr. Mayor, the City's and Local Government Devolution Bill is an opportunity for Conservative government are introducing to rebalance our economy away from London and the South East by creating a Northern powerhouse and driving economic growth across the whole country. The government, Mr. Mayor, is seeking to transfer powers away from Whitehall in a way that will provide real accountability at local level. Mr. Mayor, for too long in the Blair Brown years, local government was seen as a delivery outpost for central government. But in this chamber, we all know that local government has the ability to transform the lives of our residents, our villages and our towns. And I'm delighted we now have a Conservative government that is prepared to unlock significant powers held so tightly in the Whitehall grip for so long. Mr. Mayor, for the betterment of people of Wirral, the city region and the country as a whole. Currently, Mr. Mayor, we find ourselves attached to the combined authority model, which you will remember we councilled against. This model takes power away from each local authority, placing it in the hands of an unaccountable body, to which local people have no connection or recourse. Contrast this, Mr. Mayor, with the directly elected Metro Mayor, with powers coming from above via central government to our region, providing an opportunity for local people to have a visible local champion who they can get behind and hold to account via the ballot. In my conversations with Baroness Susan Williams, former leader of Trafford and current DCLG Minister, and Greg Clark, the Secretary of State, it was clear, as Phil did also during the LGA and other opportunities, it has been made clear that this is a golden opportunity. The bill is an enabling bill. It allows any power other than powers to legislate currently held by a minister or public body to be involved. It is time, in my opinion, Mr. Mayor, that those sitting around the combined authority top table rise above the petty squabbles in the interests of our residents. If Wirral's council leader wants to continue to be inward-looking, parochial and the head honcho of six combined authority leaders, squabbling like ferrets in a sack while vying to put prime position, then I say shame on him, Mr. Mayor. It is time to get on with the job, contribute to the creation of Northern Powerhouse, and direct the future economic prosperity of Wirral and the region. Councillor Davis will know that business leaders have been clear in their support of the Northern Powerhouse and the Metro Mayor model, so now is the time to stop being protectionist and produce a clear and coherent ask of the government. And again, in an element of democratic deficit, Mr. Mayor, I don't think any of us in the council chamber thus far have seen precisely what that ask of government is. Exactly. And I would hope that Councillor Davis will put that right. And Councillor Davis was at the LGA conference and would like me have had the opportunity to hear Greg Clark say that we are prepared to organise to be more effective and efficient. We can reap the rewards of that boldness, whether it costs, say, additional revenues generated or powers that can be invested. I've also heard Michael Heston time say, staying the same is not an option. I know he heard that if he was sitting next to me when he said it. So, Mr. Mayor, we have to take the opportunity to make decisions on matters of the local economy, skills and health. He laid down a challenge and said that councillors, local government officers and the LGA had told him what they'd be appointed that they could do things better, and his response was, why wait? Why miss the chance to break free? Take power. I understand within Merseyside senior Labour high command there is a nervousness that Jo Anderson will emerge as the candidate. Mr. Mayor, Wirral residents pay packets and job opportunities are too important to be put at risk by Labour's internal personality politics. The Northern Powerhouse provides a real opportunity to improve the lives and chances of all the people of Wirral. Therefore, this opportunity must be seized and not squandered. I commend this motion to the Council.
Thank you, Councillor Green. Councillor Phil Gilchrist, you now have 7 minutes to move your amendment.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Listen to the measured tones in which Councillor Green introduces this item, which is a change, because some of the comments are almost put in to get some members' backs up. So when the Chancellor described a key architect of the country's economic recovery, were I to be a Labour backbencher, I'd be interested in that, to say the least. But the use of the word squandered, my dictionary didn't say what I think Jeff implies by squandering. Squandering is sort of throwing money away lavishly without looking at it carefully. So I couldn't understand that. But a key element of Jeff's closing remarks, Councillor Green's remarks, were about the interest shown in the mischief making over who might be at the top or who might emerge on top, or whether Councillor Anderson from Liverpool emerges in the end. As Councillor Green rightly suggests, the project is too big to fail on those grounds. I take Councillor Mr. George Osborne's statements about believing in devolution, about believing in a powerhouse, about believing giving us more power at face value. I also look particularly at what Lord Hester has said in the House of Lords, where he said, what we want to say to the communities that make up England, you know best how you could administer the framework of local decision making. You know the strengths and weaknesses. It's therefore for you to address the diversity and complexity in putting forward your proposals. But Lord Heston also said it gave the people an opportunity to make mistakes. Now, I wasn't at the LGA, so I've had to read what Greg Clark said, and he did speak up for local government. He claimed that he'd spent many years speaking up for local government, but he did say, I will be your tireless advocate, fighting for our cause around the cabinet table and across Whitehall. So, being the tireless advocate, I would hope that he'd be able to put a case that Merseyside also says we want a system that doesn't necessarily impose their upon us. And we'd rather not have the Chancellor saying you can have any colour of car you want as long as it's black, a bit like Henry Ford. Because the Chancellor was saying at one time, well, you've got to have a Metro Mayor for this. And I would rather hope that by arguing with the Chancellor, Greg Clark and other ministers, we can get the strengths right. I know that Greg Clark did say that unity was a key issue. He said, too often differences between neighbours side by side, upper and lower, have distracted from the shared interests that unite an area. Now, I think that's precisely what Jeff's referring to, or what Greg Clark says, these different divisions must be overcome. And finally, I want to talk about a few phrases here. Jeff quoted from Jeff Clark saying, so why miss your chance to break free, he says. Take control of your fate. Organise to be more effective. Well, I'm willing to do that, and we need to find a system that, if we did have a mayor in the end, holds that mayor to account. I've been studying the London Assembly model, held by Boris at the moment, is held to account with a team drawn from constituencies and a team drawn from a wider election. It seems to me that whilst there's not all to play for, there is an opportunity to argue about what's on offer and to try and get a system, a solution that works for Merseyside and works for us and gets round the problem of certain personalities. And I approach it in that light and rather than the sort of gung-ho approach that Jeff has. If I was being unkind to Jeff, Mr. Mayor, I'd say that fools rush in where angels fear to tread. And I hope the situation is not that. We need to look at what the proposals are, to look at them in detail, to find something that works for us and not just make scoring points about it.
Thank you, Councillor Gilchrist. Councillor Davis.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just wanted to make a few points about this motion. I mean, I do have very grave concerns about the Metro Mail model. I've articulated this with all these concerns before in this chamber. I think it's a mistake for the government to advocate a one size fits all model for everywhere, because not everywhere is the same. However, we need to recognise that the government have got this policy. They're going to be in power for 5 years, and pragmatically, I accept we need to make the best of this situation. I can't help thinking that Jeff's motion is somewhat mischievous. Is this the same Jeffrey that vigorously argued against the formation of combined authority Does he not understand that if you want a metro mayor, you have to have a combined authority? The two go together. So if you reverse your position on combined authority, that's great to hear. But I do detect a sort of smidgen of hypocrisy or the thing that really concerns me about Lord Powers, Mr. Mayor, is it's already starting to fall apart. Because we heard the news last week that the government have at least put on hold the upgrades to the rail network, the electrification of the rail network going up into the north. So I hope that's not a sign of things to come, and I hope we generally do get some serious investment. But the thing that really I object to with this motion, which is why we'll be voting against, is it's actually saying we should support a metro mayor before we even know what the devolution is. For example, what powers will we get? We don't know yet, we've not got it that far. Will we get the funding to go with it? Because how many times have governments given us responsibilities without the funding? How can we ensure that the funding that we get is generally devolved from Whitehall, and they're not just devolving the blame for the cuts from the minister to local leaders? How can we guarantee that? We don't know any of these, but Jeff's saying we should embrace the metro mayor without knowing what is in the package. So I believe it would be folly to jump into the metro mayor until we know what the devolution package looks like. And I met with Greg Clark within the leaders this morning, and there is a commitment to get into further talks, but no commitment at this stage to the governance model. And I just think it would be really misguided of us and unwise if we say now we're going to support this model until we're absolutely clear that the benefits of the devolution will be worth the price we'll have to pay. And finally, Mr. Mayor, I do believe that we need to ask our residents what they believe. This can't just be a conversation between leaders and councillors and the minister. So for all those reasons, I'll be recommending that we vote against. I don't support Phil's amendment because I don't believe in assembly, which he's proposing. I don't believe there's any public appetite for that. That will have significant cost implications. So therefore, I think that is not the way forward either. So let's finally, Mr. Mayor, let's do this in a measured way. Let's see what the package is first before we decide on the government. So for those
thank
of you,
Councillor Davis.
I'll move on. Thank you,
Dan. Councillor Adams-Hayes.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, the UK economy has become unbalanced geographically over the decade. The parties of all colour. And we all need to take responsibility and do something to address this situation. We are now being given the opportunity to rebalance the divide that has arisen between the North and South. We have the opportunity to take power back from Westminster and to use it for the good of our own areas. We cannot miss out on the great benefits this should afford the people of Wirral. This isn't tinkering around the edges, moving public sector jobs around the country. This is about creating real and sustainable private sector growth across the whole country. Mr. Mayor, this is about new powers for local regions over transport, housing, planning and policing. Greater Manchester, the first to take advantage of the Northern Powerhouse project, will receive devolved business support packages, devolved funding for bus systems and also concessionary travel. Mr. Mayor, it has been made clear that these powers will not be. It has been made clear that these powers will be additional powers and not taken from the metropolitan boroughs, who will regain control, who retain control of the policy that they currently have say over. Mr. Mayor, it is time we put party politics aside, as surely we can all recognise that this has gone on under all parties' control. We need to come together for the good of the people of Wirral and for the wider region and grasp this opportunity afforded to us by the Northern Powerhouse scheme to drive the improvements needed across Wirral, to tackle the issues that have afflicted areas of our region for generations. We owe it to the people of Wirral, who elected us to represent them, to move forward on this and to cooperate fully with the proposals for bringing the benefits of the Northern Powerhouse to our area. This has the potential for a massive turnaround of fortune for the North of England, the people of Merseyside and the people of Wirral. Mr. Mayor, I support the motion before us this evening and ask that the Leader of the Council to investigate seriously the devolution package on offer with a view to seizing this opportunity.
Thank you, Councillor.
Mr. Mayor, I generally have no intention of speaking, and then I couldn't look honestly across the benches before and witness what is one of the biggest U-turns, even for the Conservatives, as they often make U-turns. This is a massive, massive U-turn, and it's also on a very, very confused logic. My good friend John Hale, who fought against the combined authority, but at least with the combined authority and the model that we moved to, we had a seat at the table. We had our leader, Phil Davis, there. And in the years gone by, in the cabinet set up, Jeff, you have sat in that seat. And if you're in there, you can influence decisions and you can get Wirral's way, as we often have. And Phil has done a great job in that position, I have to say. So the confused logic is, well, six people, including our leader at the table, is no longer a better option than one single individual with all that power vested in them once the election takes place. That is a dangerous situation, and it's more dangerous to go into it blindfolded. As the leader says, and you said, Jeff, what's the ask? Well, I'd say we know we'll influence the ask because we'll have Phil Davis there, but Will's asked what we need to be devolved down to us. But more importantly, we don't know the ask, we don't know the offer. Yes, we've not even seen what the offer is, and we've seen some poison chalices being given to us in the past. Sometimes devolving powers to local governments is a good way of washing your hands of them. See, a perfect example with public health. We were all celebrating. Public health has come home to local councils. And what does this government do to us, particularly in the north, without consultation, without batting an eyelid? It removes 2.4 million of the public health budget that it involved to us, and then says, it's all your fault, you now deliver your health programme with less money. No, it's a massive U-turn, it's hypocrisy. I trust Phil Davis, and what's more important, you know, go out and speak to people in the Wirral. You've shown how out of tune you are with the people in the Wirral. You couldn't shoot a fish in battles. You lost Wirral West to be one of the safer seat. You lost everything. You got battered. Get in tune with the people of Wirral. People love Wirral. They love their individual part of Wirral. And they do not want to be consumed without a fight, without some questioning going on. You hand it to them on a plate. I will support Phil Davis in voting against this.
David Burgess Joyce, and I understand this is a maiden speech.
I will make two apologies before I speak. The first apology is, it's a controversial statement, I am an estate agent. And I make that apology because last week I stood in a house in Lower Heslop and looked out on a beautiful vista, a wonderful view of the Welsh Hills and the River Dee. Dewy-eyed, moist of palm, it's fair to say that I realised what a fantastic place the Wirral is. And how lucky, how truly lucky we all are, because we're doubly lucky in this place. We're lucky to live on the Wirral, and we're lucky to have been given the opportunity to represent the people of the Wirral. One of the things that I find quite incredible is that we become very partisan essential that we have a seat at the table in what could potentially be something of vast importance to the people of Wirral for the future. The mantra for the Northern Powerhouse is one agenda, one economy, and one North. I agree with two-thirds of that. The North is not just one North, just like the South isn't just one South. You can't compare Lancashire with Cheshire, you can't compare Cleveland to Durham. But what I know we can do on the Wirral is make sure that we are no longer the poor relation within Merseyside. There is an opportunity for us to identify with our cousins, if want a better phrase, across the water, to make sure that the leader of this council gathers all of the people who have passion for this great place that we live in, and doesn't ignore the fact that not all of us are red or blue or yellow or green. I said that I was going to make two controversial statements. The second one really is around potholes. Because potholes are covered, apparently, in the Northern Powerhouse. And I, for one, am very, very happy that George Osborne has identified that as something particularly northern. For those of you who are in Massachusetts, my view is that there are pros and cons in everything that happens. I am a Conservative in a Labour Council. I am a Conservative in a Merseyside area. But I am deeply, deeply passionate, as I know every single person is in this room, about this fabulous place that we live in. And I doubt there's anybody here today who wouldn't want us to be at the table and the opportunity to grow this area for what it really is, which is, of course, the ratepayer part of Merseyside. Thank you.
I saw no vote on that before that was founded. Never forget the one.
and nobody sent the paper to me.
I'll give it to you.
Send it again.
And this was all I said that. We have an opportunity to take control of many of the things which have always emanated simply from London, and we can now do that, or we'll be able to do that, with the Northern Powers, which I think, actually, everybody in this chamber, as a principle, probably supports. We're talking here about the Northern and some of those we don't know yet. Why I was against the combined authority, it was a one-party authority, and it lacked democratic legitimacy, in my view, because of that. Nothing to do with anything else. And I want to emphasise that. But I believe, and I tell you this right now, if we were to have the final details that showed that the details would realise a one-party system with an elected mayor, but with only that elected mayor's party, and we're voting against it. But there's no way that we know that. I'm waiting to see the details. So therefore, what I'm concerned with, Mr. Mayor, is that we can accept tonight the idea that we all welcome the Northern Power House, that we get control of the monies which we've been asking for a long time. As far as I'm concerned, all I'm interested in is that it should be an elected assembly in the end. I hope that's the case, and that all parties, or the major parties, should be represented on that body.
Thank you, Councillor Hill. I am now going to move on to the seconders now, please. Councillor Dave Mitchell, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will be very brief. I believe our amendments were very precise and clear in the way that they were presented to improve what was put as a joke by Jeffrey and Leslie May. Quickly on the slide, I agree with the comments from the Council. They are spurious in the way of Britain. What we try to do is try and bring some sort of sense into the views behind it. We see what's happened across the river when the they decide, well, like Joe decided he wanted to be the mayor, and wasn't it? Didn't go to a rose, didn't it? Wasn't a democratic process for mayor. He just said he could be the mayor and he did it. And that's the way it's gone. I think what's happening from government, I completely agree with what John Head said. I don't think there's anybody going to disagree with having the ability to evolve all the process down to ourselves as low as it possibly can be, and actually look after ourselves with all sorts of issues, whether it's health, highways, you name it. We want to be able to look after it ourselves and have the finances to do it. What we need then is a true process to be able to do that. And I think the comments that we've made in our government actually put that in line. And it's only in line with what the council's policy is. Remember that we put, so when we go to this council, which was unanimously supported. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
Yeah, I was very impressed by
this.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I start by congratulating my colleague, Councillor Dave Smith, on his maiden speech? Mr. Mayor, we have entered an exciting era in the future of local government. But in order for us to fully benefit and to really grasp of the major opportunities before us, we really have to see some bold and visionary leadership, both within this council and within the North of England. But the opportunity of building a Northern powerhouse simply has to be grasped, because it's probably the one thing that will boost in a lifetime, really, for economic growth in the North. It's actually a revolution in the way that Wirral is, in the way that England, well, maybe Wirral hopefully as well, but the way that England is going to be governed. And this country is now benefiting from an economy which is utterly transformed from the wreck that was left by Wirral. We are now, Mr. Mayor, evolving as one of the dynamic countries within Europe. Employment is at a record high, the deficit has been halved, and while the ailing Eurozone teeters on the edge of chaos, our annual growth is actually running at a healthy 3%.
What about food banks?
Mr. Mayor, we have stuck doggedly to our recovery plan in the Conservative Party in the face of the relentless shroud waving from the left. And now just let's look at what's happening. Let's look at what's happening if we hadn't listened to the left. What is happening in Greece as we speak? It will probably disappear into an abyss. Mr. Mayor, the Northern Powerhouse is an opportunity once and for all to corral the North population into a collective force that can begin to rival that of London and the South East. And we all know, Mr. Mayor, that the North-South divide needs addressing, and it needs addressing once and for all, because clearly that will be for the benefit of rural residents who will benefit hugely from that. It will let us stand on our own feet for once and ultimately let us create a better place for the people who we represent to actually live in. The case for devolution and the Northern Powerhouse is undeniable to everybody. But in order for us to actually reap the benefits, local authorities must change to gain. There has to be clear political accountability with the powers invested in an elected metro mayor. And that is the huge difference to all that has gone before us. There will be one person who is accountable. Mr. Mayor, collaborative local leaders must put aside their dogma and their political divides, and they must work alongside each other for the benefit of the people who they purport to represent. This is, in turn, Mr. Mayor, will create a vision for the North with a vibrant and growing economy that can build on our existing strengths in the region, and it will attract huge investments. The Northern Powerhouse, Mr. Mayor, obviously cannot be built overnight. It's a long-term growth plan, and clearly it will have serious and long implications for the future, and particularly this region of the country. It means prosperity and security for the people here in Wirral, as I think it was my colleague here mentioned. It's one agenda, one economy, and one North, and we clearly have to embrace this radical proposal to ensure that we secure here in Wirral, for our residents, a place in history for our region. We must be bold, Mr. Mayor, and we must seize the opportunities with both hands that are given to us by this Conservative government.
Thank you, Councillor Rennie. Can I move to Councillor Green for the West of Reply?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I think I'll try and be brief.